Now then, if you have a look at any of the newspapers this morning, that's the front page of the Mirror. There she is on the Sun. And of course, the Times there, her face is all over the papers. We're still waiting for the release of Faye Turney. She's one of the British naval personnel arrested by Iran last Friday. Yesterday, she was forced to appear on Iranian television.
They were very friendly, very hospitable, very thoughtful, nice people. They explained to us why we'd been arrested. There was no aggression, no hurt, no harm. They were very, very compassionate.
She also wrote a letter. Whether she was forced to or not, we don't know, but here's a little of what it says.
We were out in the boats when we were arrested by Iranian forces, as we had apparently gone into Iranian waters. I wish we hadn't, because then I'd be home with you all right now. I'm so sorry we did, because I know we wouldn't be here now if we hadn't. Please don't worry about me, I'm staying strong. Hopefully it won't be long until I'm home to get ready for Molly's birthday party with a present from the Iranian people.
It's a very human thing, suddenly, when you talk about her daughter and her daughter's birthday party. Joining us, former RAF navigator John Nicol, who was himself captured by Iraq during the first Gulf War, and body language expert Robert Phipps. Thank you very much for coming in. John, you've been there, you've been paraded on TV. We know only too well those images of yourself. What do you think was going through her mind as she was sort of portrayed like that?
Ben, you know, just looking at those pictures makes me fill up, to be perfectly honest. She's trying to send a message to her family, to her loved ones, to say, I'm OK, keep going, you know, keep holding on. But, you know, she's in an almost impossible situation. You said we don't know whether she was forced to say those things. She was coerced into doing it. No serviceman or servicewoman would want to voluntarily go on and say those sort of things after being captured. How they coerced her, I don't know, and that doesn't really matter at this stage. But, you know, just to see her and to think about how her family will be reacting, to look at those pictures, to see their loved one, and, of course, the families of all of the other servicemen who are captured as well, who haven't seen pictures of their loved one. It's an incredibly, incredibly difficult, difficult set of circumstances, and it just goes to show what our men and women in the armed forces are going through on a day-to-day basis.
The pictures we saw of yourself, you'd been beaten up and you looked very, very tired. Robert, you were nodding then when John said that she was being coerced. Is that something you'd picked up in her demeanour and her manner?
Well, just the way the monotonous speech and the way the actual speech was delivered, putting aside the body language, but the actual way that it was delivered to give a specific message to the people watching. It wasn't delivered for her family watching. It wasn't delivered for the British government. It was delivered for propaganda purposes, for Iranian TV and across the Arab world.
And John, this letter as well, I'm assuming that she must have been forced to write that or coerced in some
way. Well, when we say force, what I'm saying is that she would not voluntarily want to say those things. There's no doubt about that. You know, she would not want to be put in the position that she wants to be in. But, you know, when you're in that situation, you have to do whatever it takes to placate the situation. We're not in a war with Iran. She's not doing anything wrong. She's not giving anything away. She's doing exactly the right thing. She's placating the situation as much as she can. And hopefully it will benefit her and the other hostages. And we might see a resolve soon. Sooner rather than later.
Of course, there's some suggestion that she may be released, and a lot of the focus is on her because we know that she is a mother, and like I said, that's a very human thing to be able to, tangible thing for us to hold on to. I would imagine, and I'd certainly, you can sort of disagree, that she wouldn't want to be released without her colleagues, would she?
I absolutely agree with you, Ben. She would not want to be singled out for any special sort of treatment. There's no doubt about that. And you say, yes, she's a mother, but, of course, there'll be fathers there. There'll be loved ones. Can you imagine seeing your wife there or Kate seeing her husband there? The whole point is that these are the men and women of our armed forces are normal people like you and I, and they're doing an incredibly difficult job in impossible circumstances, but they're human beings at the end of the day. None of us are superhumans, so she wouldn't want any special treatment.
Robert, you talked about the tone of voice. From the pictures, she looked quite healthy. She looked sort of quite together. Was there any other sort of particular sort of nuances that you spotted?
Well, although she may look like that, inside, she's going through complete turmoil because her head is cast down, and when she's looking down and to the right. This is our emotional channel, and when we get involved in deep emotional feelings, we look down and to the right. Also, when she's smoking the cigarette, when you're feeling confident and outgoing, you blow the smoke up or straight forward, but she took the cigarette and she blew the smoke down. Again, a negative, very unconfident woman.
And I imagine that, I mean, she's obviously been, she's being forced, I'm assuming that religiously she doesn't wear a headscarf, usually she's being forced to wear the headscarf as well, so it's another way of the Iranian forces suppressing their...
Well, I think, Ben, if you've seen the pictures where she was interviewed on board her ship a few hours before that incident took place, she's a bright, bubbly, confident member of Her Majesty's Armed Services. She comes across as wanting to do a job, being proud of her country, being proud of the Navy, and it's a completely different person. And again, from my own experience, I know exactly what that feels like. You don't want to be there. You don't want to be in that position. From my personal experience, personally alone, you feel as though you're letting the side down. You don't want to be singled out. You don't want to be saying those things. But it's incredibly important that she cooperates as much as possible with whatever the Iranians want her to do, because that is the only way that these people are going to come out. This is not a military matter anymore. This is in the hands of the politicians.
OK, well, let's hope that we can see a resolution very shortly. John and Robert, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Thanks.